Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to validate a digital signature and the different ways to digitally sign a PDF document using the Blazor PDF library. I open an existing Blazor Server application where I have already created a PDF document with digital signatures using the Syncfusion PDF library. If you want to know the steps to create a Blazor Server app and add a digital signature to the PDF file using the PDF library, then please refer to the video link in the card above. First, I remove the existing code from the Create PDF method, because I am planning to load an existing document. Also, I define another method called SignExisting with memory stream return type, and will add the code to sign the existing PDF document. Within this method, I retrieve the file location using the web hosting environment variable and read it as a file stream from the specified location. Then, create an instance of the PDF loaded document class and initialize it with the file stream object. Look at this PDF document. It has an unsigned signature field, and now I am going to add a digital signature to it. To do that, first I get the signature field instance from the document fields collection and store it in the PDF loaded signature field variable. Then to add the signature, I create a PDF certificate using the PFX file and its password. Following that, I create a PDF signature using this certificate and assign it to the signature property of the signature field instance. Here, I am planning to add an image to enhance the signature appearance, so read the image using the FileStream object and create a PDF image using FromStream API of PDF image class. Then define a standard font with a name and size to display the text in a custom style. Next, I will proceed to draw the signature on the PDF page, which involves drawing text, shape, or image using the signature instance. Before that, get the graphics instance of the field, and I will use the signature field bounds to draw these elements. As a first thing, I draw a rectangle shape. And the image within it. Secondly, draw the text to describe the signature. Now, I have completed adding the signature. So, save the document to the stream and return the saved stream. Then, I call the SignExisting method here. Let's see the output of this code. Look here, the signature is added to the field and the image and text are also added for the signature. Okay, next let's proceed to see how to sign a PDF document with an external signature. If you need to automate the signing process for a large number of documents on a server with its own HSM, then you can achieve it using the PDF library. Let's see the steps for this. First, I create a method called external signature. And load a PDF document that has no signatures. Then add a signature by passing the null value to the certificate argument. Here, this signature object has an event that allows us to create a certificate and embed the digital signature into the PDF document. So, let me define this compute hash event handler. and get the document as byte array. Here I am going to use the SignCMS class to create a certificate and CMSSigner class to sign it. And these classes are available in the System Security Cryptography NuGet package. So, I open the NuGet package manager and search for the System Security Cryptography PKCS NuGet package. And install it. Here, I import the required namespaces to use the SignCMS and CMSSigner classes. Then, I initialize the SignCMS instance with the document byte array. And create the certificate using the PFX file and its password. Next, I initialize the CMS signer with the created certificate and set the digest algorithm to it. And then compute the signature using the compute signature API. Then, I encode the digital signature and embed it into the PDF document. Now, call the event compute hash within the external signature method. Save the document to the memory stream and return it. And in this create PDF method, I am commenting the call to sign existing method and call the external signature method. Now, let me run the application. I open the signature panel. Here you can see the newly added signature and its details are listed. There is also another secure way to store the digital ID by using the Windows Certificate Store. For this, you need to retrieve the digital ID X509 Certificate 2 from the Windows Certificate Store and use it to add a digital signature to a PDF document. So now, let's see the steps to sign a PDF document using the Windows Certificate Store. First, I create a method called Windows Store. And load the existing PDF document. Then, I create an instance for the X509 store, using a specified store name and store location. Next, I get the existing certificates from the store in an X509 Certificate 2 collection variable. And retrieve the first certificate from the collection. And use it to create the PDF certificate. Now let me create the signature using this digital certificate. Save the document to the memory stream and return the stream. Then, comment the code for external signature method, call in the create PDF method, and call the Windows Store method. Let's check the output of this code. In the signature panel, you could see the signature is marked as valid. Here, this Syncfusion certificate is already added to the Windows Store, and it is used here. Next, I will show you how to sign a PDF document with long-term validation. Once a PDF document is signed with an LTV signature, it will be valid for the long term, even if the root certificate is revoked. Let me first define a method called LTV. As shown before, I load the PDF document and add a signature to it. Then, set the required signature properties like cryptographic standard, the digest algorithm, and add a timestamp to it. Now, let me enable the long-term validation by setting the enable LTV property to true. Save the document to stream and return the saved stream. Here, comment the Windows Store method call. Then make a call to the LTV method from here. So far, I have shown the steps to sign a document with the LTV. But, I can also sign a document with long-term archive timestamps. To know more about this, kindly refer to the link in the card above. See here, in the signature panel, LTV is enabled. And the signature standard is set to BLT. You can also create LTV in an external signature using Syncfusion PDF Library. If you want to know more about this, refer to the link in the card above. Following that, I will show you how to validate the existing signatures in the document. First, I create a method called validatePDFSignatures. And load the PDF document with multiple signatures. The validateSignatures method is available in the PDF loaded form field collection class to validate all the digital signatures in the document. To do that, I create a variable for the list of PDF signature validation result, and it will have the information about each digital signature and its status. Here, using the validateSignatures method, I validate the signatures in the document. This method will return the value true if all the signatures are valid. If any one of the digital signatures is invalid, then the result will be false. Let me add a breakpoint here to show you the validation result at runtime. I am commenting this code here and call the validatePDFSignatures method. Look here, all the signatures are valid. You can also see the signature details here. Lastly, I showed you how to validate multiple signatures. Suppose I want to validate individual digital signatures. Let's see how to do that. Before that, comment this code to validate multiple signatures. First, I iterate the form fields in the PDF document. And if the form field is a signature field, then get that signature field instance. And I add a condition to check whether the signature is present in the signature field instance. Then use the validateSignature API to validate the signature. Here I add a breakpoint to show the validation result of each signature. Suppose the signature is not valid, then you can remove it from the document. To know more about this, refer to the link in the card above. Now let me save and run the application. Look here, each signature is marked as valid. Next, I will show you how to validate signatures against a trusted list. I can create and pass my own trusted list of certificates to validate a digital signature in a PDF document using the Windows Certificate Store. I create an instance for the X509 store using a specified store name and store location, and get the existing certificates collection from the store in an X509 certificate to collection variable. Here I just change the validate signature API with the argument certificate collection so that the signatures will be validated using it. When I check the isSignatureValid property, it is true for all the signatures. Let's see the final output of this code. In this PDF document, the signatures are marked as trusted and valid. Let me recap what I have shown so far. I showed you how to sign the existing signature field in the PDF document and sign using the external signature. I also explained how to sign using the Windows Certificate Store and create LTV signatures, and how to validate the signatures in the PDF document. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.